Hey friends, I'm Sean from Draft Therapy, and while I'm usually out and about talking about craft beer, today I went to my local store, saw something a little bit different. So as you've noticed from the title and from these cans, this is called Mom Water. Now, Mom Water isn't really a seltzer, it's actually a fruit-infused vodka water, so it's not carbonated at all. There shouldn't be any kind of pop when the can is opened. And another thing that separates it from seltzers is there shouldn't be, at least they say on their website, there shouldn't be any bloat or anything like that related after these are drank. And if, since I haven't mentioned it yet, this is canned in Indianapolis, Indiana by Mom Water LLC, and I picked up an assorted 8-pack for this video. We're going to do a quick rundown of the flavors available, but first I'd like to thank my executive producers Brian Kramer, David Jeffries, and Cam Freeman for helping to bring this review to you today. If you'd like to become a producer, help out the channel, maybe just throw me a couple bucks to buy me a beer, or maybe even a Mom Water. Take a look at my Patreon. It's at patreon.drafttherapy.com. It should be linked. You should see a little scroll here where you can get early access to these videos, and there's a few other special perks that are available only to patrons. Also, I wanted to mention that these four flavors in front of me are currently the only four flavors available. They're only these four. You can expect to pay right around 19 to 20 bucks for an 8-pack assortment of these flavors. You get two of each, I believe. Or you can pay about 10 bucks for the 4-pack of flavors individually so far. So let's get a real quick rundown of the labels. They are all very similar. I'll just kind of run down what the flavors are. What we have first is Julie, which is a passion fruit flavored mom water. All these are zero carbs, zero sugar, 90 calories. So if you are maybe on a low sugar diet, low carb diet, whatever, these are perfect for a drinker like you. Then we have Linda, which is blueberry peach. We have Sandy, which is coconut mango. And we have Karen, which is lemon blueberry. As you can see, the cans are all very attractive. They have different colors to kind of let you know which is which. They have the fruit or whatever kind of fruit combination are in these so that you know which is which. I'm gonna use these little small glasses so I can pour them each individually and we're not gonna have to worry too much. I'm not really gonna do a whole taste test. I'll just let you know what my favorite one is out of the four. And we're going to start with Julie up first. I'm going to crack these and you're going to hear what you're going to hear from the crack. Let's see if you can hear this. And there wasn't really any kind of pop. I mean, there was a little bit. It's the gas escaping that was in here. But as you can see, this is like water. I mean, it's super clear as you would expect the water to be. I'm going to have to put these next to each other because there's no way that I'm gonna be able to tell from looking at these which are which. This one is Linda, it is blueberry peach. Again, very clear. I'm not even gonna mention that they're clear because you should just be able to notice that these are all the same. We're gonna do Sandy next. This is the coconut mango, and I can smell, they have really great aromas. They have a really nice kind of fragrant aroma. They're not too much, it's not too strong of an aroma, but it's got a nice aroma to it. And last but not least, we're gonna do Karen. I have tried these before. The only one that I've been able to try so far has been Sandy. And while I'm not generally a coconut kind of flavor person, I do think that it's got a pretty nice kind of crisp, clean flavor. And so I'm just gonna run through all these. We're gonna start off first with Julie. Like I said, this one is passion fruit. Give it just a kind of little sniff here. It's just got a really nice fragrant aroma. It's not overpowering, it's not in your face. This is great on ice. Or even maybe as a mixer. You really do taste that passion fruit come through. It's not overly flavorful. So I'm a person that the seltzers that I like to drink, the hard seltzers I like to drink, are the ones that have just that real faint, just like the regular non-alcoholic seltzers that you drink. I like the ones that just have that faint hint of a flavor, something that's infused with a flavor and is not overrun by the flavor. So it feels like you're drinking a fruit juice, but it's really a seltzer. Like, that's not something I'm generally into. This is blueberry peach. Definitely taste the big blueberry flavors. The peach is a little bit more subtle. I don't know why I'm looking to pour this one again. This is Karen. This one is the lemon blueberry. It has a nice lemon kind of crispness to it. It's a little bit more refreshing. I think that the lemon blueberry Karen is the most refreshing of the group so far. And then last but not least is the one that I've tried before. This is Sandy. It is mango coconut. Yeah, definitely getting the coconut. I would say if you're not a coconut flavor kind of person, like I generally am not, especially in alcohol, it can kind of come across too much. This is a little bit too much, but it doesn't, it does taste like real coconut. It doesn't taste like suntan lotion, you know. It's not like way over the top getting flavors that are just like too much. So out of the four, I mean, they're all very similar. They all have the same kind of mouthfeel. They're very light. They're very crisp. They're very refreshing because they are water-based. They're not, you know, it's not a beer-type beverage. It's not a ready-to-drink beer-type beverage. But yeah, they're all pretty good. I think my favorite, honestly, has to be Linda, the blueberry peach. It has that nice blueberry in there, the peach. And I think a really close second for me would be Karen, because the lemon is a little bit, has a little bit more of a refreshing, like a hot day kind of refreshing take. But I think it really, it comes down to personal preference, depending on what kind of flavor in general that you like. I would say that if you're big into passion fruit, you can't go wrong with this. Like I said, you could even amp these up by adding more vodka to them. I would probably stick with vodka because they have, it already has that really clean flavor. It doesn't have, sometimes seltzers, hard seltzers, I think, especially something like White Claw, can kind of have that malt beverage flavor, can kind of come across as being vodka, even though it's not actually vodka. The only ones that I've had that I really think that I've liked that are mass produced are the High Noons, because I feel like they have a little bit cleaner of a flavor for a hard seltzer. Those are vodka infused seltzers. So they have that nice kind of same kind of flavor profile. The only thing that's different is that this is, that those are carbonated. This is not. As you can see, I'm kind of swirling this around just to give you an idea. There's some bubbles rising up, but it's not carbonated. If I was shaking a seltzer around, it would probably, you know, be fizzing up right now. So this is probably more of a dirty glass than anything else, and maybe these other little speckles that you might see in these glasses. But yeah, so that's been Mom Water. These are, I think these are really good summertime drinks. I don't think I would see myself drinking these in the winter, but they're just a really kind of overall good flavored drink. They're not overly powerful. The flavor that's in it isn't overly powerful. So it's something that you could drink on ice, something you could drink just cold, maybe even straight out of the can. And it's more refreshing than I think a straight seltzer, which I find seltzers to be quite refreshing as well. But just because how light they are, there's none of that carbonation. There's none of that carbonation bite to them. And I feel like that is just a really good kind of drink to have in the summer. I feel like that these probably, you wouldn't be suffering from the bloating as much. And like I said, at zero carbs, zero sugar, just 90 calories each, this would be perfect for somebody that's on like a ketogenic diet, or maybe somebody that's avoiding sugar or low carb just in general, or someone that doesn't, you don't want to get weighed down by drinking a few drinks, you know, out on the beach, out on the deck or whatever. And you could drink a few of these and probably feel pretty good. They're 4.5% alcohol by volume. So again, they're not breaking the bank, and it's something you could drink all afternoon long, if that's what you wanted to do. When the kids are away, the moms will play. All right, friends, that's been Mom Water. Have you seen it on shelves? It's available right now in 10 states, but there seems like they're pretty quickly growing. Have you seen them on shelves? Are you curious? Have you had this? How do you think it stacks up against hard seltzers or maybe any other kind of ready-to-drink options that you might be into? Let me know in the comments down below while you're down there. If you like beer, or you like Mom Water, or you like ready-to-drink beverage, you might want to subscribe and click that bell. I'm here talking about them twice a week. Tuesdays and Thursdays is all for free for viewers just like you, and you might miss your newest favorite if you're not subscribed or getting notifications to the channel. So until next time, I'm Sean from Draft Therapy. Thanks for stopping by. Remember, drink craft beer, drink craft seltzers, drink non-carbonated vodka-infused fruit drinks. But whatever you do, just support your local businesses. And until next time, don't forget to treat yourself to a little draft therapy. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time. Cheers.